Let's investigate how XState can be used to scale to any complex requirement. I've got a very simple project here to show you what I mean. We've got a fetch button that when I press it, goes and fetches the details for Luke Skywalker. And the code kind of looks like this. We're using a data set data thing here. When we make the fetch, we are setting the data to undefined and then grabbing the information when we return the data from the Star Wars API. And here the button just clicks make fetch. But there's a little wrinkle here, which is if we click this fetch button multiple times on a slower connection, you can see that it doesn't cancel the in-flight request when it's in flight, you know? So we can actually press this fetch multiple times, and eventually we're going to start hitting our rate limits on this API. It's going to start punishing us for this. So we need a way to prevent the user from fetching when they're already fetching something. One thing we can do is we can have a state set state here, which has a fetching or idle state. And when we make the fetch, we can set the state to fetching and then set the state to idle when we're complete and cancel any fetches that come in if the state is fetching. And you can see that this works. It means that when we press this multiple times, it's going to resolve the one that's in flight before it's done anything else. But I consider these patterns here, this sort of set state at the start of fetching, set state idle at the end, it's going to be a bit of an anti-pattern. For instance, if this fetch fails, we're going to be stuck in the fetching state. We kind of need a way to do this declaratively. Enter XState. We now have this fetching machine where we can make the fetch, it enters the fetching state, and when it's done, it goes back to idle and we can fetch again. Exactly the same behavior as we had just before with React. And our button looks pretty similar too. Instead of just firing the event handler, it sends the fetch event to the machine and the machine handles the event. Now the cool thing about XState is now that we've got this in this visual language here, we can start thinking about all the edge cases that we didn't think about before. So now we need to think about errors, right? That's the first thing that comes to my mind. When we encounter an error in the fetching state, we're just going to go back to idle, but we're also going to add an error message and display that on the screen. To show it on the screen, we can add an action into our onError, which is going to be show error message. And that's going to then need to be implemented inside our actions in here. And we're going to need some extra data for this. So we're going to go const error message equals use state. And so here, what we can do is just say set error message, something went wrong. We can test this by changing the network to offline here and making a fetch. And you can see that something went wrong is now being logged. But I think we could do better. I think we should do some exponential back off here where we retry again and again, sort of at a further and further distance to see if it's going to work. The way we can do that is add a new state here, which is waiting before retry. When we get an error, we can actually go there instead. And now here, what we can do is just point back here and change this to an after event, which is going to say after a few milliseconds, we're going to go back there. Let's change the duration to, let's say, after 2 milliseconds, or maybe after 1 millisecond, or 1 second rather. And that's now going to bounce back to fetching after a second. If we simulate this, we go fetch, we encounter an error, we wait a second before retrying, and then we fetch again. All this time, you can't refetch because it's automatically retrying it for you. Okay, let's try this out. What we should see is when you click fetch, it's retrying again and again after every second. Now this is going to really bother our API if something on the API is going wrong, so we probably need to back off further and further every time we see an error. So we don't need a lot of things to make this work. I've added a dynamic delay instead of the static delay that was here before. And what this does, it means we can pass a function here. So this can read the error count, which we've now got in state just here. And every time we encounter an error, we're going to increment the error count. Every time we actually get a successful result, so we enter the idle state, we're going to reset the error count, and we're also going to clear any errors that we encounter when we get to the idle too. So what this means is we have this exponent here, which is counting the error count, and it sort of times it by 2, and that means we're going to start at 200 milliseconds, so it's going to start hammering again pretty quickly, but then go up to 400, 800, 1600, 3200, and start exponentially backing off. And that's all the code that we need to implement this. So now let's check that this works. We are offline, and when I fetch, it's going to go bam, 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 and if I then go to online, when it gets to here, it's going to load the data properly and not display the error message anymore, and we're good to go. The exponential back off stops. Pretty nice. We could even go further here if we want to. Let's say we added a new timed out state, for instance, and after, let's say, 10 seconds of trying to fetch, we just go into here and we say after whatever, and suddenly we've got timeout logic all working here too. You can see how XState really can scale, and everything that we've captured here, even these relatively complex requirements, It's all in this pretty simple visual tool here, and it's visually editable back and forth. If you want to try this out yourself, you can go to stately.ai/editor and just try it out, you know, like just make some state machines, you can export them to code and check out how it works with XState. I think you're going to enjoy it.